families fleeing, children separated from parents for months on end. It sounds like war, but it's the reality of COVID. A dad who left his four-day-old son before lockdown, expecting to be reunited within weeks. A new bride who hasn't seen her husband in 14 months. As the globe continues to battle the virus, these are just some of the stories of desperation to come home. Tonight, in this one-hour special, we meet five families who share their personal footage and private pain as they try to bring their families to safety.
New Zealanders are being urged to come home as the coronavirus outbreak worsens.
Countries around the world are imposing strict travel restrictions. The options for New Zealanders to get home are reducing dramatically.
At no time did we think that we weren't going to get back within a few weeks.
No.
Tuesday the 4th, Wednesday the 5th are exactly the same. Economy's all sold out.
Suddenly all the flights were shut down. They were grounded essentially and we were stuck here.
All packed and ready to go.
And we kept telling the kids, you know what? As long as we're together, we'll be fine.
I know a lot of people back home think, oh, people should just stay there, but, you know, we're New Zealanders. We just want help.
It's hard.
I called my wife. She said, we're at the airport, we just booked in the luggage. And I had to pull the plug.
Your very first kiss as husband and wife.
It's been 14 months since I've seen Vina.
I actually cry every single day. I miss my husband that much.
Our borders remain a crucial wall of defence, one that'll be contentious though as the rebuild takes over.
We organised to go to my mother-in-law's for Chinese New Year. We woke up the next morning, everything is going to be closed today because of this outbreak. We could see the army roll into the main highways. They ran around every apartment, every building, the army, locked every door, every floor, and every building so no one can get out of anything. That was it, lockdown. We'd see video clips on our WeChat, people getting dragged out of their house. Obviously infected, thrown in the back of vans and taken off to isolation points. Ambulances just rolling through the country and it added to your panic. And I need to look after my daughter. I need her to come home.
Tell me what it's like in Wuhan at the moment.
It's a deserted, it's like a scene from The Walking Dead, to be honest, off the movie. It's there's no one out there. It's 11 days now, and all we're surviving on is what we've had for Chinese New Year's. I know a lot of people back home think, oh, people should just stay there, but, you know, we're New Zealanders. We just want help. We need help. For me, it's just wanting to look after my family.
It's hard.
I'm Richard Hart. And this is my wife, Helen Hart, and our son, Will Hart. We're from Taranaki, and at the moment we're stuck in Cornwall in the UK.
My sister was battling cancer for 6 years, and she took a turn for the worst.
So we needed to get back here to support our family and obviously say our goodbyes to her.
She passed away sort of 3 weeks later. And
but at least we were able to have a funeral with 10 people in the crematorium, all socially distanced.
Yeah, very clinical.
I've got all the trolleys that are keeping you from going that way and everybody's still social distancing, queuing up.
At no time did we think, though, that we weren't going to get back within a few weeks.
No.
Well, of course, the spread of the virus was continuing and more places were closing down.
So we were due to come back on May the 5th. Yes, May the 5th. So, and unfortunately, our flights were cancelled due to the lockdown.
Come up tonight to get some fish and chips. We can't go into a shop.
As time went on, it became apparent there was no way we could get home, right? So, yeah, we were stuck. Very stuck.
Hi, so we're the Ramans.
And we're about to be moving home to New Zealand during the chaos of COVID.
I think this was one of the first countries to implement lockdown. We live in a gated compound, which is very common in the Middle East. And you literally noticed one day there was just nobody outside anymore.
It was surreal. I mean, it really was surreal.
It's surreal. It's still surreal.
Yeah.
Everybody wash your hands, please.
Anxiety levels are high because we were desperately keen to keep the virus out of the house.
I miss seeing my friends.
What about you?
I think it's so much fun because we get to do school in our pajamas.
Yes. Yes. Our plan was always to go back to New Zealand this year.
COVID hit and then suddenly we were asking the question, are we able to go? Suddenly all the flights were shut down. So we had to make a decision, should we repatriate ourselves in an emergency situation or should we stick to our plan, which is to leave in July? We had an animal that we needed to transport. So we had to make the decision to just stick with Emirates and hope that they would be running. Fingers crossed it all goes to plan, but ultimately we don't know.
Your very first kiss as husband and wife.
And my husband's name is Fizi Italia Pahulu. He's known as Venasio. We met online. We were together for 6 months, yeah, before we got married. I think we knew pretty quickly. Vena was working for the RSC scheme. RSC scheme is the recognised seasonal employer, and they employ Pacific Islanders. Vena comes from Ha'alalo, which is a small town in Tonga. He has been coming to New Zealand for the past 3 seasons to work, and he sends that money home to his family. When I went there to Tonga, I never seen that level of poverty ever in my whole entire life. Once me and Venom married, he was no longer eligible to be on the seasonal program because he's married and to New Zealand citizens, so it changes his status. We were told we didn't meet the requirements for a partnership visa because we hadn't lived together for long enough. So the plan was to apply for a working visa, and that entailed Vena to have to go home and apply for a new visa. And so 1 week later, lockdown.
What's it, Jess Copy? But tell me, what's it?
That is
kabukariki.
And it's me as bang.
Ah! I'm bang, I can't be pee.
And I brew.
In late 2019, we were still living in Richards Bay. My daughter is quite young, and my wife was also pregnant. We found it extremely, extremely difficult to get employment. I think I applied, at one stage I calculated it was almost 100 jobs. And the pressure started building. For quite some time we were looking at New Zealand, and we just decided this is the right time to do it. I was fortunate eventually to get a job offer. And I left on the 10th of January. My son was 4 days old. And my daughter at that time was 5 years old. Said goodbye to them. It was long tears. And I promised her it's just a short time.
What is happening?
I'm going to cry.
But let me tell you something. Roy, what? Roy.
Yeah,
that is.
Yeah!
Yay! We ended up booking their tickets for the 20th of March.
From 11:59 p.m. tonight,
we will close our border to any non-residents and citizens attempting to travel here.
I immediately called her and I asked, you know, where are you? And she said, they're grabbing a coffee, they just booked in the luggage. And I had to pull it back. I could still remember my daughter's voice. She was saying, is it Dad? And it hurts to know that that's how close it was. If it was a day before, they would be with me now.
Hi, hi. Be quiet, Kiwi. Hello, Papa. Daddy's just got home now. You're on your way to school, and I just got back from work. Okay, you guys. Oh, I miss you too, my darling.
We never thought it would take this long, going well over a year, going to 14, 15 months. It just feels unfair. We never expected that.
We read on the news earlier on that five people had escaped from Hamilton facility. Why? It just pisses me off.
Going from a clean situation to a airport to on a plane with lots of other people, it's going to be a bit nerve-wracking.
Stranded Kiwis in China will touch down in Wuhan overnight after the deadliest day of the coronavirus outbreak.
Everyone's very excited in all our chat groups. A lot of people haven't slept.
I know the food situation was pretty dire. How has it been since we last spoke?
We managed to order some food online somehow, and they dropped it off in sanitary bags at our door. It's not like we're feasting on three-course meals or anything, but it's okay. Going from a clean situation to a airport to on a plane with lots of other people, it's going to be a bit nerve-wracking, especially if someone's coughing. I've had a friend just posted that she's been rushed off to hospital, that she's diagnosed, so it's pretty bad, you know, especially when it's friends and family. The big relief is we're coming home.
We're driving down a motorway with like 15 million people in the city with nothing. No cars, no bikes, no buses, no nothing.
See, we're fully covered up. We're almost at the airport now, so things are getting a bit more exciting. Can't wait to get home. See family and friends. Hey guys.
Hi. Hello.
Hey, are you excited?
Yay!
Yeah. Just saying goodbye to her parents.
Oh, it's now 8:30 at night. We're still standing in line.
Hello.
And most people were here since 2 o'clock today.
We come back with 10 kg little bag. That was it. I think we mainly just had clothes and some jandals. We had to go through heat scanners and some people failed, so they got taken away. And we're like, were they standing next to you? You're so stressed about catching anything and passing it to your family. Finally got through for the security checks. And here's all the Air New Zealand staff standing at the door and you're like, oh. And it was so good. Like, I just looked at my daughter and my wife and was like, yes, it was, as you can tell, it's a good feeling.
Any luck today so far?
Nothing. Because I was the one checking the emails and trying to find the flights and things, it started to get quite depressing.
Tuesday the 4th, Wednesday the 5th are exactly the same. Economy is all sold out.
Okay, the seats are not available for July.
As of now. It's just day after day after day, and I don't think there was a day that we didn't check or didn't ring or... No.
We read on the news earlier on that five people had escaped from Hamilton facility. Why? Why? It just pisses me off.
It really ripped my kilt that they did that and put people like us wanting to come home at risk of not being able to come home. You know, I was afraid that they were going to stop those quarantine hotels, isolation hotels, because people were doing this.
You're there for a reason. It's only 2 weeks. Just suck it up, stay there. Just...
And I found myself in a real black hole at one point because I just couldn't get my family home. And I felt responsible for that.
I'm just waiting for the computer to warm up so I can check Air New Zealand to see if there's any flights. I have a feeling I know what it's gonna say. But we live in hope. Dreams are free.
Dubai, Auckland, 1st of July 20, one daily 8.
Yay! Yay!
Awesome.
What have you been up to this morning?
I've been saying goodbye to all my friends and teachers because it's the last day of school.
Aww. You didn't get to say goodbye. It was awful.
I'm going to miss you too. Bye. Have a nice summer holidays.
All the rugs are gone.
We were super stressed that things weren't going to go to plan and that we weren't going to make it home.
All packed and ready to go.
And we kept telling the kids, you know what? As long as we're together, we'll be fine.
Hi, Abu Dhabi. Gosh, you can't even see the buildings because of the dust.
Dubai is essentially a different country within the United Arab Emirates. So when we left Abu Dhabi, we knew we couldn't go back. You couldn't cross back across the border.
Crossed over in Dubai. We're all off to a hotel in Dubai to sleep there before the flight.
Tomorrow.
We're all getting pretty excited.
If for any reason we weren't able to actually get on the flight, we would have been stuck in Dubai, which meant, you know, hotel costs, no visa, the potential to be overstaying, just so many things that were very stressful.
All right,
you've
got
the key. Has everybody got a mask?
No,
I need a mask.
The door.
Have you got a hand sanitizer, lovely?
Yeah, in my jacket pocket.
Okay, Pia, put this in your pocket.
I have to be honest, we were petrified that we had left our bubble, our home and the places that we knew were clean and that we were cleaning ourselves, and we'd exposed ourselves in the journey.
Alrighty. Yeah.
Every moment we were waiting for someone to say, no, sorry, you can't get on the plane. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Ready?
Yes.
Hey guys.
We made it to the gate and we were like, okay, we haven't got on the plane yet.
Thank you so much.
And then we got on the plane and we're like, OK, we haven't taken off yet.
Here we go.
And then the plane took off and we were like, yay. Yeah. We're on our way.
Never really envisioned that it would last this long. We just thought, you know, there's a health crisis and we're just gonna have to wait it out. Like, I woke up this morning crying. It's been over a year and it doesn't get any better. I stay in contact with Venice family here.
Kia ora.
How are you?
Good. He's not in that position to support his family anymore, and that creates hardship. Okay, you butter it and you put it on the plate. I
see it as my duty to support my husband. We still share all those household bills. My household just got a little bit bigger, and so now I support Tonga and here at home. So this is the album that we did for Mum when Vena went back to Tonga. The immigration advisor in Tonga told us in February that we now had enough evidence to apply for a partnership visa. These are actually the only visas that are being processed at the moment as partnership-based visas, and that's the one we want. You know, marriage certificate's not going to get us across the finish line. You have to be able to prove that you're in a stable relationship.
Tolu fa. Ne no fa unzakala ho tonga. Pe mana tua ati se o fo fo na. Ko hai na se me a. Te o fa ki ma lava ke ki fo ke ma ya. That's our first verse.
Even being a wahine toa, I don't have the answers. All I know is that you just work hard and you should be rewarded for that hard work. And so I'm still waiting, yeah.
Having crushed the virus here, our borders remain a crucial wall of defence, one that'll be contentious though as the rebuild takes over.
When they created a border exemption process, we kept applying and applying, and I think we've applied 15 or 16 times. The excuse given to us each time is that the borders must remain closed and there is no space in MIQ.
A wave of relief today as border exemptions clear the way for the US and UK challenges for the America's Cup.
The Wiggles, given wiggle room in our already crowded managed isolation facilities.
100 people have been given exemptions to enter New Zealand for the stage production of Lion King.
It just started, you know, to be honest, getting ridiculous. And that's a slap in the face to everyone in our position. My wife and other families who are bringing skilled work, they will be tax-paying residents and citizens eventually, whereas some of these actors and producers and sports people, it's a quick in and out and then they're gone again. At one stage, it was only about 800 family members that are stuck like my children. You can almost look at a plane load of people. And then the issue is solved. These families are reunited and they can continue with their lives.
Why do they have to travel all the way from Auckland Airport all the way to Hibiscus Coast to get quarantined? Couldn't they just get quarantined over in Asia?
I've got big shoulders. At the end of the day, I can sort of relate to both sides of things.
How would you feel if it was your family that was stuck?
Kiwis were desperate to come home and some managed it. The relief of touching home soil is overwhelming. But as you'll see in part three of the Sunday special, the welcome home mat hasn't been rolled out for all who've returned.
Touching down on home soil, an Air New Zealand charter with medical experts on board, bringing passengers out of the coronavirus danger zone in China.
Landing in New Zealand, I think everyone got out and kissed the ground, to be honest. Oh, all this weight's come off my shoulders.
Arriving under the cover of darkness. More than 150 people settling into this North Auckland Defence Force base for the next 2 weeks, quarantined from the outside world. Locals turning out late last night to welcome their new neighbours.
Glad that we can accommodate them and give them that welcome, you know, that they deserve, and they must feel like they need it.
But not everyone has been so welcoming.
Why do they have to travel all the way from the Auckland Airport all the way to Hibiscus Coast to get quarantined? Couldn't they just get quarantined over in Asia?
There's heaps on your Facebooks and your Instagrams and the news. There's heaps of negativity telling you to stay over there. You deserve to be there. You know, you went there, that's your problem. You deal with it. I put myself into their shoes. People are just scared. So they lash out because they're trying to protect their own as well. I've got big shoulders. At the end of the day, it's just, we don't need to hear it. You know what I mean? We've been through enough.
I was looking through a Facebook page and Duncan Garner was on there.
He's called people like us that haven't got back to New Zealand lazy. And we're not needed.
And that really got me upset because he doesn't know everybody's situation.
I just find that really hurtful. If we need to have a test before we come home, then I'll do it. If we need to pay for quarantine, then I'll do it. But please don't have a go at us.
The situation is already playing with your mental health. It really hurt.
How would you feel if it was your family that was stuck?
You just had to find things to amuse yourselves and just keep your spirits up.
I'm William Hart, and this is why I should be the milk by adult. I'm a big kid at heart, and...
You've got to stop yourself from going stir crazy.
I don't think that'll get on TV.
We were quite good at doing that.
Get it as a... that motion.
So we've managed to get our refund back and the air points are coming, so this is more doable.
The transit countries were starting to open up and so we were able to book a flight, and then we got within a week of the flight.
We had an email from our
flight operator.
That's it.
Emirates Airlines.
Telling us that our tickets have been cancelled. So now we're in a situation where we aren't heading home. We'll obviously have to get hold of our employers and...
Things are a little bit of disbelief at the moment. It's a bit shock still sinking in that we can't get home yet.
1, 2, 3, woohoo!
It's 10 a.m. and the temperature is 14 degrees Celsius.
When we got here, it was just such a relief. It was like, oh, you know, we're home, thank goodness. And the whole idea of 2 weeks in quarantine was actually a pleasant thought because we were here.
It's
a bit different to Abu Dhabi, isn't it? Did you see out the window earlier?
Yeah, I know, it's cool. It's raining crazy.
But that's an easy part of the journey.
They did a test on day 2 and day 10. And both times we were just, you know, holding our breath that nobody in the family was going to come up positive.
Are you still okay?
And we were lucky, I mean, yeah.
Quarantine day 3. What's going on in here, monkeys?
No network.
No network?
No!
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 The world has ended.
Where are we?
Legs.
In our exercise area.
Yeah.
There were a couple of people, I think, who walked past the hotel who weren't very pleasant. And the New Zealand Defence guy said, look, you know, just be careful. Some people aren't very kind and they say bad things and stuff, especially with the kids. We watched the news and we read the papers and all of the news reports, etc. For us, it didn't really bother us, ultimately. You know, we were on our journey and we had to come back.
Hello, mother-in-law. How are you?
I'm fine.
Yeah?
I'm fine.
Wow, what a journey.
Picking up Poppy.
It's really good to not be wearing masks.
Yeah, I'm sure it is.
Yeah, and we're lucky it all worked out, really. But it wasn't easy.
One lucky thing about all of this is I've got my family together. First time in 20 years. My 3 children.
All in the same country.
She's ignoring me.
I know.
Yeah, these are some of the things that we bought for my boy. So we brought things a little bit bigger. So it's up to 3 months and some up to 6 months. My daughter went through a phase where she wanted this mermaid tail. Those rooms are sometimes the best thing for me. and other days, the absolute worst. When you hold those things and you realize how much time has really passed, it's more than 14 months later, they're still not allowed entry into New Zealand. Somebody mentioned to me that maybe should I maybe put the stuff in storage? I said, no, this is about the only link that I have with them at this stage.
Hello, Daddy. We're at the beach. It's so high.
So we miss you. Splashing in our face.
The water's splashing in our face.
You want to be together. You need to be together as a family. Having the kids by me, I think it's my life-saving thing to not break down. Emma Bella is a strong little girl, but she gets her moments where she totally breaks down and she cries for him. Every afternoon I pick her up, she asks me, do I have any news for her? You are just in limbo because you don't know when. There's no answers, there's no light at the end of the tunnel.
Hello. Hey guys. What are you doing?
Just sitting here.
You're still awake at least. It's getting late.
So ready for bed? Yep.
Okay. And what did you do today?
Went to school.
No, what? Anything interesting? Anything cool today?
She has to throw away her lunch.
Oh no. And where's the little monster?
Sleeping.
He's awake. Yeah. He's awake. There he goes.
They're fast asleep, Daddy.
Did we wake you up now?
Hello.
Hello, Papa.
Hello, Daddy.
He's happy. I'll let the little guy go. Good night, my darling. I hope you have a good night. Good night, love. I love you guys.
Love you.
Bye. I feel like I'm on another planet. Like, I feel so, so far and so useless in a way. I started to really crack end of last year, and I went to see my GP, and they've set me up with a counsellor. I never had a need for that. But that is how low you start feeling. You're depressed, alone, you panic, is it gonna work? And I think my wife is going through the same thing. I have had people ask, isn't it maybe better to go home? Is the best thing for me as a father to leave? Or is the best thing for me as a father to stay? If I go back to South Africa, we could be unemployed for, it could be years. Now, I have two children. So my son is only 1 year old and my daughter's 6 and I have a wife. So I cannot do that to them. So as much as this hurts us, at least the outcome might still be worth it. Where my children have a great future, and we have a great future. There's too much on the line, and you would hate to be in a position 6 months later where you see families returning, and then it's gone, the opportunity's gone.
Oh, it's been authorized.
Oh.
Verify your itinerary. Heathrow to Auckland. One way, 3 passengers. Oh, it's been authorised. Oh.
Well, it's a beautiful misty day to leave the UK on. Hopefully, our plane is still flying.
I mean, even when we left where we were staying, we were still waiting for an email or a phone call to say it would be cancelled.
until we were on that second flight home from Hong Kong, we weren't sure that we were gonna make it.
That's 2008. And that's 2020.
Not long now.
Where's the terminal?
There we are.
Oh, New Zealand carpet.
I was just so, so happy to see that airport carpet. From when we left home to the day we got home, it was 6 months to the day.
This obviously had a financial strain on us. There's no doubt about that. Bills have to be paid. And when you've got no income,
it's easy sitting in the stands watching, but I'd rather be doing it.
We're not able to do Speedway, and that is our life. That's been our life since forever. I think it's had a pretty big impact on us, to be honest.
Yeah. Yeah.
Big things this year, so very happy. Got my little boy, so I got a boy and a girl now. He's almost 9 pounds at birth, and you know, he's 55 centimetres, so he's obviously not taking after Dad, who's short. Hey? What are you making, Taylor?
The hospital.
Cool. Everything's still over in China. We have all our stuff's over there. It's just work in progress, you know. You do what you can. But when you start with nothing, you come back, literally nothing. You just got to rebuild. Have you seen an ambulance before, Taylor?
Yes.
We're doing well. And we're happy, that's the main thing.
Do you miss Nana? Nana's doing China. Mm. I really wish I could bring my family over, but I couldn't because they didn't have a New Zealand resident. Do you want to say Happy New Year to Nana? 说新年快乐奶奶，跟奶奶拜年，新年快乐，新年好红包。哎，妈妈，奶奶，喊奶奶。
We talk to her every day. She misses Liam and want to cuddle him all the time. Hopefully the borders can open sooner.
They've had some more outbreaks out over there in China at the moment, so everyone lives in fear still. We were some of the lucky ones. Hopefully he's daddy's boy too, like my daughter.
3, 2, 1, go! Whee!
They're super happy.
Yeah.
There's so much for them to do here, you know, compared to back in the UAE. But before we left, very, very rarely saw any friends, you know, because we all tried to stay in our bubbles. I remember Kisa getting super excited about the fact that she could hug people.
We feel very fortunate to have come out of an area that was sort of, right now, I think they're still getting 1,000 cases a day.
New Zealand nailed it. It was awesome. Yeah, did a great job.
Go!
Been 14 months. We have to endure. I have to put a brave face on. I have to truck on. For the first part of our separation, I just imagined him always flying in here, but now as time goes by, it looks like it may not even happen. I may have to fly there. At the moment, our advisor's gone missing, so I cannot locate her. I haven't been able to locate her for the last 2 weeks. We have the option of finding another one. And going through that process again, or we sit tight and we wait for those borders to reopen.
Hi, sweetheart.
How have you been this week?
You look well, babe. Have you been getting your groceries every week?
Yeah.
Yeah?
And you?
You know, I'm working really hard to get you home, but for now, it may be that we have to wait longer. Yeah. It's not going my way, but life doesn't go your way. We're gonna have to figure out how to get around this. You just be strong and wait for me, okay? Goodbye. I love you. Ufatu.
I love you too.
Okay.
the best thing I can hope for is that restrictions begin to lift, meaning if we start getting vaccinations or get a COVID passport, that we're going to be able to see families reunited. I can't tell you what that looks like, but I just want to be with my husband. He means the world to me.
There are a lot of people literally stuck. We can't leave. And we're just hoping and praying that our families will come eventually.
Oh, that's a really, I want to say nice sign, but you know what I mean? That's well done. Nobody wants to make these signs.
It is a fear starting to build that what if this just doesn't work out? If the government had to come forward at any time and say, we've made a decision, they will not enter, then that's game over for us.
Our sole purpose for today is we're having a peaceful process. It's just gone too long now. And we feel that the government is in a position where they have started with vaccines, so the first line of defense have been protected. So it is really the time to start looking a bit broader at other categories of entries.
The Trans-Tasman bubble that I do hope will be announced today will give us some hope at the end of the tunnel. We will keep fighting and I will not give up. You have my word. Thank you.
We don't want to give up. There's too much on the line, and you would hate to be in a position 6 months later where you see families returning and then it's gone, the opportunity's gone.
And so what will that day finally mean to you when you do get to be?
I've played that in my head a million times. I have this picture where I sit outside the hotel, because it obviously won't be the airport. I sit outside the hotel and I give them a call and they say, okay, just wait outside. And then they walk through those doors. So I'm looking forward to that. Yeah, it's going to be a good day.
Oh, you can feel it, can't you? Now, since we finished filming Henkor, who we just saw, he applied for critical purposes visas for his family in South Africa last week and is hoping they'll be united next month. As for Renee, whose husband is still in Tonga, she's resigned to the reality that she'll have to wait for borders to reopen until she's reunited with Vena. She says she's trying to remain positive.